wouldn't do it, would
he? He's in tears.
Oh, spoils ball.
And then we've got steps. Poor Gethin intimidated by the tragedy.
Oh. Feeling delicate.
He could probably, he probably can. He probably just doesn't.
What do you think?
It's simple, isn't it?
Well, forgive him, he's a Welshman. Just saying.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, lovely to see you here all this morning.
Morning.
This is a bit of a first for us because we've got five people here in the studio.
No.
There's lots of new things going on right now, isn't there? People are able to perform again. Mm-hmm. You're making music again.
Yeah.
Number one again.
Go on.
Again!
Explain.
Well, we've woken up this morning to the lovely news that our brand new album, What the Future Holds Part 2, is number one in the UK and Australia on the iTunes charts.
Oh, hey, congratulations! Who'd have thought it?
You know what? Seriously.
Well, you say 25 years. There's always joy remembering steps over the years. Here you go.
It's time to begin. I'm counting in. 5, 6, 7, 8. My boots scootin' baby is driving me crazy. My obsession from a western. My dance floor date. My rodeo, Romeo. A cowboy got from head to toe. Wanna make you mine, better get in line. 5, 6, 7, 8. Many.
So, we're doing some mathematics here because each was just saying that in the videos he can see all of their children like with those younger steps.
Yeah. Younger.
Can we say hello to the children because they're all watching?
Are they?
No, mine should be at school.
Yeah. Mine's at school.
But hi.
Mine's only 6 weeks old. So
oh, okay.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
So is there, is potentially a mini Steps Mark II.
And more.
Yes. Very much.
How many between you? How many children are between
Eight
between
us? Together, yeah.
Okay, so you have an even more expanded version. Whose is the oldest of the children? Who's got the...
My Charlie. He's 14.
14?
Yeah.
And the youngest?
Youngest, 6 weeks.
Six weeks old. 7 weeks today, actually.
Oh. 7 weeks.
And what does... Tell us, is it Charlie, your 14-year-old?
Yes.
Great name. What does he make of you know what you do now, but also, I mean, I know you're all guffawing looking back at the old videos.
I know.
What does he make of the whole?
Do you know
thing?
What? That we don't. I don't think I've really sat down with them and showed them all
Why
the old
you?
Stuff. I don't, no. We just never have. They've been a part of all the new chapter. But, I think they would probably... I think he would be mortified, quite honestly.
Well, that's what I was going to ask. Do you think, I mean, because he's a teenager and
you're
not really sure you want to see your mum on stage dancing.
No.
Well, look, I've got a teenager, Jaden and Star Lily, they're watching, and they think we're the best band in the world, so it's very nice. Yeah.
And we are,
at the minute.
Mine still think I'm an ice skater from Dancing on Ice. They do.
That's the best, though, isn't it?
Fabulous. So, look, you guys have been busy. So, we were seeing Sarah on Morning Live there, Sarah Cox, who was part of the Radio 2 Live as well. Yeah. What happened there? You managed to perform. I know it was pre-recorded, but you're in front of an audience.
So exciting. We haven't been able to perform live in front of an audience for about 3 years now. So, it was the first time us together on stage with an audience. They were seated, so they couldn't get up and dance, but we still had you know, big confetti cannons and they were still sort of chair dancing.
Lovely warm-up.
It was
lovely
great.
Warm-up. Amazing.
You know, we had Louise on the sofa this morning as well. Yeah. She was talking. Did you say hi? Was it very show busy?
I trained with Louise. I went to stage school with her.
Did you?
In London, she was the year above me. So, she's lovely, beautiful girl.
Yeah, she was talking about just having that vibe from the audience. And I know you said kind of they were sitting down, but that's what you thrive for, to do, isn't it?
It's just the look on their faces. Even though they couldn't kind of get up and dance and shout and do all the moves, just... It's
the
almost
energy.
Just the joy and the energy on their faces because it's been such a long time we've been able to perform live. And, you know, we were meant to tour last year and it's all been moved to November this year. And it's a nice little taster of what we're going to get in the next couple of months. It's just so exciting.
It's great when they can get up and dance, though, because if we're going wrong on stage, we can just look at them. Oh, that's where we are. Yeah.
That happens a lot.
But, of course, you don't forget anything at all.
No.
Isn't it some kind of, like, muscle memory? Don't you just... Yeah. Is it?
There's a certain extent, but we've got so many different versions. We've got TV edits and arena edits and summer tour
dance
edits.
So,
I think all the old choruses are just
embedded.
But the Radio 2 gig was... like a little warm-up show for our own tour. So it was amazing to be in front of real life human beings. It was amazing.
Well, I know on the tour you're going to be doing a lot of the older stuff, yes, as well as the new stuff, yes, as well. But while you're doing the older stuff, who looks at whom to make sure they're getting, if they lose their way in terms of dance moves?
Oh, that's a really unfair question.
Who's looking?
I think we all have a moment.
We're not here to be fair all the time.
I think we're quite easily distracted as well. There's lots going on, and there's always like loads of great things in the audience, you know, flags and banners and posters saying all sorts. So that's always good fun.
Lyrics is my. It's more so lyrics than dance moves.
I'm singing.
Sometimes I just start, I'm like, oh, it's meant to be. I should be singing.
My bad.
Now, I think we're going to see one of the new songs. Let's have a listen now. What's this
song? That one's
Take Me For A Ride.
So the dance moves pretty...
Just a bit of this, a bit of hair, kind of gel in the hair.
It was, who came up with that then?
The choreographer.
Is that a technical
term? Good money for that.
Is that a technical term for the dance move, the hair gel?
Well, you just you can name it so you remember it. So, yeah, just...
Yeah.
We give, a little dance...
I dare say you have quite a bit of fun when you're coming up with those things, don't you? Because it is... I mean, is it slightly tongue-in-cheek? I mean, because they're so stylized and there's the five of you doing exactly the same moves.
Yeah,
absolutely. I think, you know, we started out, in 97 doing a line dancing single and we were put together just for that. And then it's kind of evolved over time. And now people expect the formula of the fun pop song with the dance move. And, yeah, we have a laugh doing it. And you've got to imagine people having a laugh doing it in the clubs as well. So, into club.
And we into We have to remember it as much as the audience as well. So they've gotten simpler over the years.
You were trying to remind Charlie earlier, weren't you, H, about...
The thing is about steps routines, anybody can do them, and you can do them from the comfort of your own home.
Sat down.
So we've got a tragedy. Come on, Charlie.
Easy.
There you go.
We tried this, and that you were saying earlier on. I have actually genuinely completely forgotten it. Apparently, during the pandemic, we spoke, and there was another occasion in which you tried to teach us.
And you've erased from your memory, clearly.
Yeah, you joined in last time.
I can't really. I honestly can't.
Shall we have a little call now? Do you want to join in?
It's very
easy. Come on, so two hands.
What are we doing?
Tragedy. There you go.
We're doing tragedy again.
Charles did it with us. Can do that.
Can we just repeat? We're all doing tragedy. Okay? Everyone's involved. Everyone in the studio too. Come on now. Look up. Look over there. Yes.
Okay. Go on then.
Go on, tragedy.
It's that's
the
it. Just do that.
You're not even doing it.
Oh, I'm waiting for you.
Stop avoiding it. Charles did it.
Step one.
So tragedy. That's literally one.
Is Naga doing it? I'm not letting you.
Yes, she is.
Come on. No, she's not doing it. Actually.
There's your still. Got him.
There we go.
Can I just confirm? Now they're doing it behind the cameras. Okay, so
tragedy.
Yeah.
Well, actually, we can go to another song. Deep Shade of Blue is this one. Do this.
Yeah.
Like,
right.
What's that called?
Deep Shade of Blue.
We've got One for Sorrow. So One for Sorrow. And two bad.
This is what everyone's going to be doing like when they come and see it.
What the future holds is this one. So you're kind of opening and
the most amazing thing is when we're on stage, we look out and everybody does it. And
why
I think
wouldn't
that's
you?
The
that's
unique
joy.
Thing.
Yeah. It's joy.
That is the unique thing about us,
you
I
need
think.
That.
Not everybody's got that.
What?
That kind of the whole audience joining in. Everybody joins in with the song and singing along, but to see 15,000 people doing that is just incredible.
Yeah.
Well done, though.
15,001.
I was about to say that.
Yeah, there's always one.
There's always one.
Is there never?
No.
Oh, come on, there must be.
Just you, Charlie.
No. I think it's been a difficult time for everyone, and we're here to lighten the mood and spread a bit of happiness, and everybody needs that.
Good. You absolutely have. You absolutely have.
So.
I'm loving the coordination.
Thank you.
As always.
Brilliant.
Thank you. It's our superpower.
Our stylist, Mike.
Good luck.
Thank you so much.
And the album is called What the Future Holds, Part 2. And it's number one in...
iTunes.
UK and Australia.
It's out today.
All over the world, out today. So thank you for your support, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And Charlie.
Also.
I know.
So let's take...